Tim O'Shaughnessy, sorry, it's close. Creative director of college sports at ESPN. Technology is huge, right? So for all of the college stuff we do, which is some of the stuff I'm about to show you, we need to pipeline a lot of it. I mean, there's a lot of crazy renders going on. You know, you really can't build these asset-based systems and crank out 130 team identities if you don't have technology. So, yeah, you made that comment like the love affair is starting up again, right? Like, that's so funny. Because it's, yeah, I mean, I guess it's true. I don't know if it's ever gone away, but there's got to be at least a faux love affair or else none of this stuff would get done, you know? So, okay, I'm obnoxious because I have a couple, well, for many reasons, but I have a couple of reels to show, which is basically the two networks that Nick was alluding to. So, you know, bear with me. I know there's a lot of reels going on right now. So, essentially, the one thing to think about is that the identity of these two different networks are the same. You know, it's sort of one skeleton, two skins, and that's the approach that we took to it. We designed these two different networks at the same exact time with the same team, with a lot of the people who are in this room. And I'm just the dude who's talking about it. There's many more impressive people behind me who made it between our art directors and our creative staff and our producing team. And then Gil at Troika parted up for about half of it as well. So the ACC network is essentially a new network that came out due to you know, us realizing that there's a good opportunity in that space. This conference has a lot of a lot of brand integrity. So all you do when you really design a conference network is dive into each team pretty heavy, and we played off of puzzle logic and the oddly satisfying themes. But I just kind of want to get through these to get to the next point, so we'll rip through the reels. Again, the same type of deliverable list, the same type of elements, both of them are asset-based systems. So when you see a team puzzle, you have a complementing team tile system in the SEC, trying to hit on different vibes for the different conferences. One's intelligent, three-car garage, engineering section. The other's tailgate, ruckus. Hey, bought out your, I'm supersonic with the vinyls. Hey, my credit card didn't go through, I'm balling, I feel like I'm Goku.
I'm supersonic with the vinyls. Ay, my credit card didn't go through. I'm ballin', I feel like I'm Goku. Ay, ay, yeah, come again. Ay, yeah, feel like I'm Goku. Ay, my credit card didn't go through. I'm ballin', I feel like I'm Goku.
Okay, cool. So You know, there's a portion of this panel that is like stuff you've done over the last year, and I think there's a lot of interesting things in those two packages that we could talk about for a while in terms of system builds and strategy. And I think we have an entire day, so if anyone has any questions, you can literally find me or Marissa, who's out there, or a bunch of us who worked on it. But a couple of other quick points before I pass it to Jordan, because I also feel like a big portion of this is stuff that we think is interesting. And you've all alluded to it, right? So GPU is going to be everywhere really soon. Everybody loves sexy renders. We've been all about this for a while. It's been about 4 years in our space that we've had some Octane influence, but very marginally. But I think in the next year or two, you're probably going to see that grow a lot. You know, yeah, everyone's building farms. We're all getting there.
As far as trends go, I think we can definitively say that 2D is taking a backseat now to really sexy 3D photoreal renders. I mean, there was that
2D text on top of 3D, though. I think that's pretty trendy, though.
Oh, that, yeah, I know, in trendy combination, yeah. But
and necessary.
If you remember, like 3 years ago, you know, it was all about minimal, flat, you know, super European, yeah, graphic, yeah, and now. Yeah.
I once attended a BDA conference in, I don't know what city it was, but it was in the 90s, and someone said, we produced this without using any 3D, and the audience went, yeah, and they all threw it. So it's
the
a
way
pendulum.
It's like bell bottoms, you know, eventually they'll be back in. Yeah. I put this in here because I think it's really important. If you've ever heard me speak, you know I think the college space is really influential. And I think that there's a new thing happening in signing day. In signing day, you're seeing all these micro packages come out from schools. There's two signing days, the unofficial, the official. And Texas and Ohio State, Georgia, any big program is putting out a lot of interesting content between filming plates, tracking, and some awesome typography animation. And this stuff is going to become pretty influential. I mean, just following Matt Lang in Texas and what he does, he's setting trends left and right. So to the point of type and sort of over-design, also, every piece of reference I'm seeing from everybody on Earth right now is just tons of typography, tons of pattern, tons of things that really create chaos. Yep. So, you know, some of it's organized chaos, some of it's just chaotic. And, you know,
with
the refinement.
With that, a lot of collage. I mean, it, as evidenced in the two packages you just showed, you know, it's all collage-based because you have the power to be able to render that.
No doubt, no doubt. So you're going to see that everywhere. You're already seeing it. It's pretty implicit. And then product design. You know, this is in there because I look at this, and I think a lot of other people do. Like, we're all looking at insert layout and trying to add some more detail. But, you know, the UI space is where all that stuff comes from. Clean product. And then lastly, you know, I think this needs to change. I don't think it's collegiate influence anymore. Everything that I see that anyone's doing in the television space, for the most part, I've seen somewhere on a college handle. There are so many people out there designing stuff all year long for players and teams and things that they need to get excited about. It's hard to find a new typographic trend that hasn't been done somewhere else.
And also fan work, fan art.
Fan art, no doubt. And then it extends beyond college into actual team space, because now the teams, you know, every pro team has their own thing too.